What you're looking at right now is my collection of magnets, amassed from years worth of scavenging all sorts of devices, totaling at over 40 pounds. In this video, I'll show you the best places to find magnets and the fastest ways you can extract them to use in your DIY projects. Speakers of all sizes, from subwoofers to earbuds, contain relatively strong round magnets, and I found the fastest way to separate the magnet from the basket, which is the cone-shaped part, is by crushing it in a bench vise. The basket simply crumples under pressure, and you're left with a magnet on top. Alternatively, if your vise isn't large enough or if you don't own one at all, you can hammer a flat screwdriver between the magnet and the basket or separate them simply by sticking the screwdriver in between and twisting to pry them apart. I found this method also works well for huge subwoofers that are too big to fit in my bench vise. Gather up your old phones and pop off their screens. You might have a bunch of magnets waiting to be scavenged as well. And speaking of phones, headphones and earphones are also great sources for magnets, and wire cutters make quick work of this process. The strongest neodymium magnets I've ever found were in desktop computer hard drives. These aren't meant to be serviced, so manufacturers try to make them as hard as possible to open by hiding screws under stickers and by requiring different sized Torx bits. So I'll leave a link to a set I recommend in the description below. The size and thickness of these magnets vary, and therefore the strength as well. Hard drives from laptops tend to be much thinner, and some even have only one magnet, so if you happen to open one and don't find what you need, keep looking. These are always stronger than any others you'll find considering their size. Laptops, AirPods, flip cases, and especially tablet cases all use strong magnets to overcome the distance between them to remain shut. Next time, don't forget to hack them apart for the magnets before throwing them away because you might be missing out on a gold mine. Optical disk drives from desktop computers, or for that matter, any device that reads CDs requires magnets to operate. I tend to find these optical disk drives everywhere since they're basically useless these days. You can find a set of 2 to 8 small but incredibly strong magnets next to the laser lens, and usually also a powerful disc magnet on the rotor as well. The next source is what inspired this video. I happened to come across this broken exercise bike, and after taking it apart, I found a ton of ceramic magnets in the flywheel, more than in anything else I've ever taken apart in the past. I suppose these are used for creating electricity or to increase resistance while biking. These magnets tend to be very brittle, so to prevent them from chipping while I release them, I thought to bend the steel they're glued to so the adhesive fails first, which was mostly effective but not perfect as a few still broke. For some unknown reason, microwaves are known as a common source for harvesting magnets, but doing so can actually be quite dangerous. To get the magnets, you need to locate the magnetron. Inside, there are two colored beryllium insulators. Scratching or breaking these emits dust, which is extremely toxic if inhaled, so in short, it's a really bad idea to mess with them. These magnets also aren't very strong. The lack of a pole piece, which is what directs and condenses the magnetic field to the center in speaker magnets, means that it's much weaker than a speaker magnet of its equivalent size. Some of my best inventions utilizing these magnets are this magnetic Japanese saw guide, which holds the saw square while I use it, and my homemade bike rack, which has a magnetic mount for the lock. I'll link these videos below as well as others I recommend you check out. And in the meantime, don't forget to subscribe to my channel so you don't miss my future videos.